In this lecture, we are going to develop code for uploading files via JavaScript. We want to create a web page with a button, like this one, that when clicked lets you pick a file and then it will send it to the server. Here is the template code to display the button. I already put it here because most of it is not particularly interesting and I just want to go over the main points. So there is a Boolean variable uploadDone which controls whether we display the button in this div or whether we just display the name of the file uploaded. In this div there is an input of class file input type file. This is what creates the button. And we listen to the change event. When the change event is triggered, it means the user has selected a file to upload. And we will call this upload file function defined in our Vue controller, in our Vue object, passing it to it the event. And the other variable is this uploading, which is used to display a spinner when the upload is in progress. So we have these three variables, upload done, uploading and uploaded file, and we have one method. And most of the interesting action happens in the JavaScript, so now we turn our attention to it. So here is our index.js. We can declare the variables, so uploading is initially false. Then there is a uploaded file, which is the name of the file uploaded. We leave it empty at the beginning. And upload done, this is also false. The other thing that we need to do is declare the method. Okay, there is the method to upload the file, and so we call this method upload file. We called it already upload file app.upload file, and then we can code it. And you know, here is the really interesting part: app.upload file is equal to a function that takes an event. This is the change event in which the user has selected the file. And now we must do something with it. Okay, so I say let self is equal to this. When this is called, there will be an event that is passed to us that acts as context, and I will store it in self also as reference. I'm not sure if I use it, in fact, but a habit. So let's look at the file. Let input is equal to event.target. This is why I need the event. I need a reference to the input object in the web page that triggered the event. Then I say let file is equal to input.files of 0. There are ways to configure the input element in such a way that you can select multiple files at the same time, and then you could also upload multiple files one after the other. But the code I'm building here is done to select a single file and upload a single file. I think you could change it without too much difficulty to do the multiple uploads, okay? Now the change event, I never trust that that it actually gives me a file. I mean, most of the times it's true, but you could have just maybe erased it. I'm not quite sure, so I want to test that the file is actually there before I do anything. Okay, so if we have a file, now we have to upload it. And so I can say app vu uploading is equal to true. And then I can say let file type is equal to file.type. Let file name is equal to file name. Let full URL is equal to, so this is a part I haven't told you, but the controller is already generating for me an upload URL to which I will be sending the file. And in index.html, there is already the portion where I have this file upload URL. So the file upload URL is ready. And the point is that what I'm missing is the way of communicating the file name and the file type. Because what I want to do is that I want to send the file itself as the content of the request. In really in binary form, I want to just ship it up. And so I have to find another way to send up this file name and file type. So what I do is this, I take the file upload URL and I add to it these parameters. Because the file upload URL is already signed, I simply can use an ampersand and add the file name portion and then also the file type. So I need to URL encode these because, you know, not every character can be part of a URL. So I have to say plus encode URI component, this one, of file name. Okay, plus, I can say plus here. Plus, same for file type. Okay, plus encode URI component of file type. So this creates the URL I want to actually use. Okay, I'm just a little bit worried that this is colored in this funny color, but I think that this declaration is correct. File upload URL. I don't think I've made any mistake there, so I will just live with it. So once I have this file upload URL, I need to start the actual upload. And so how do I do the upload? So if you look at the blogs and various tutorials on the web, they all tell you, oh, take the file, create a request with, say, access or your favorite library, and then set the file as one of the components of the upload. Essentially as a part of a form that contains the upload. So they encode the upload as part of a form in which there is a name file and associated with it the file content. Remember that when we do a form for in which the user can enter data, that's also uploaded as a form. But in this case, I really do not want to follow any of those tutorials, because if you send up a file as part of a form, the file itself is encoded, I believe in Base64, in such a way that it is safe for transport as part of a form. And this bloats the file by a certain amount, by some 20% at least. Okay, so you send 6 bits every byte, essentially, instead of 8 bits every byte. So what I want to do is do a request in which I just send up the file as is. The content of the body of the request will be the file itself, without any transcoding. This is much more efficient on the CPU and is more efficient on the space. So in order to do that, I have to go actually back to the bottom level libraries that are built into every browser. If you have wondered how the Access library is built, the Access library is built on the basis of some primitives that browsers make available. I mean, encode URI component is an example of these other primitives, right? But there is also a primitive way to do a request. People prefer to use the Access library just because it's slightly more beautiful. But the basic capability, the basic library that every browser offers for doing requests is actually quite fine. And it's the best way I have found to actually send up a file without having to transcode it into any way. So the way we can use it is as follows. We need to create a new request object with this underlying library. The underlying library is called XML HTTP request. Okay, so I create a new request. Sorry, I forgot the new keyword. So I'm creating a new object in JavaScript. Once I have this new object, I say request add event listener. So I want to listen to the completion of the upload because I want to mark in the UI that the upload is done and what the file name is, okay? And so I want to listen to the load event and I want to, when it has loaded, to call this function. That what does it do? It says app upload complete. Okay, and I want to pass it to the file name and the file type. Okay. So this is what I do. That's it, actually. I don't need to do anything else to the event listener. Then I created a request. I added a listener. Now I need to associate with it a URL. Somewhat counterintuitively, this is called the opening the request. So this will be a put request to my full URL that I built. And this parameter is true. This parameter, as you can see in the hint, says that it's asynchronous. Okay, and this will be, by the way, a streaming request. So the file will be streamed up. It's you know, you have seen it for sure. When you upload a long file, the file is slowly piped up, you know, into the request, so to say. And so created the request, added the event listener for completion, associated the URL with it and established how it has to work. And now I say rec send of my file. So this actually causes the file to be uploaded. Okay. And so here I can close this function. And the only other thing I need to do is build the event listener. Build this upload complete function. And I will put it above, actually, because it needs to be declared, right? If I put it below, then this reference will be not found. So I put it here, app.uploadComplete, app.uploadComplete is equal to a function that takes a file name and a file type. And what does it do? It just does some UI bookkeeping, app v uploading is equal to false, app v upload done is equal to true, so that I show the file name, and finally app v dot uploaded file, okay, uploaded file. Yeah, these hints are both useful and annoying, is equal to file name. Okay, oh, here I should have really put this to be more consistent. Okay, and the file type, I don't use it. I mean, I could display it if I wanted. So this is all I need into the JavaScript. I don't need anything else. And so the only thing extra that I need to do is build the controller to receive the file upload, and then we can test this whole thing. Okay, this line in the end wasn't needed, so let me just remove it. Good, let's go build the upload endpoint. So here I need to build an action for file upload. I mean, often you would need to typically check permissions, so is the user logged in, etc., etc., but I don't care in this moment, okay? We just want to take care of the upload. And so I do action file upload, okay? So I define the endpoint, you know, corresponding to this URL, no? And I remember to put method is equal to put, because we chose put as the method. Put is the preferred method to upload content. You could do post, but in a post request, you more typically want to send up a form. A put request is ideal for sending up a file. Okay, so action, uses, you can complete, but we actually don't need anything for our experiment, okay? Def file upload. And so here, what I want to do is this. I need to fish out the file name is equal to request params get file name. And I need to do the same for the file type. So let me just cut and paste this. Not sure it's faster, but... So file type is equal to file type. So these parameters actually come from the URL, right? But I want to fish them out because typically the server will need to store the file name or do something with it, and the file type is always useful to have. But now comes the important part. Where is my file? So if you are wondering where the file went, you can go look at the bold documentation at the request object, and it will tell you that the request body is a file-like object that you can read as if it was a file. So you can say uploaded file is equal to request body. That's all there is to it. So this is a file. And so at this point, all you need to do is perhaps print out some diagnostics just to check that everything worked. Print uploaded file name of type file type. Okay, and then you can say print content. So it generally would be a crazy idea, right? But just for testing, I want to print the file I upload. This obviously works only if I upload a text file or an HTML file, which I will do for the testing. If I uploaded an image, I would, you know, print gibberish. But so I told you that uploaded file is the file. And so in Python, a file, you can read it, right? A file is a file descriptor, is a file object, and it has a set of methods defined on it. You can go look in the Python library, but basically you can read it, you can you can read a line at a time, or you can do various things like that. And so here I just read it, okay? And here I say then return okay. The return value is not used. So that's what I have to do in the controller. It's basically actually absolutely easy. It's three lines to fish out the file name, type, and the actual upload. And then I can do what I want with it. Okay, so so at this point our code is complete, and we can move on to testing the code.